Anuenue. Wow, it's been years.
Oh, that's right. You've been to Anuenue before, haven't you, Millie?
Uh-huh. I used to attend the School of Magic here.
I thought you said you were a sheltered girl who...
Well, I was. My trips to and from the school every day were chaperoned. I traveled by ship, but they never let me look outside even once. All I saw were my bedroom and the school. Room, ship, school, ship, room. That's how it went, every single day.
Oh.
Hey, Millie? What's school like, anyway? I wouldn't really know.
You just... study. A lot. The School of Magic is supposed to be for people who care about continuing their education. But I wasn't like that at all. Sure, I did the work and learned the lessons, but what I really wanted was to see all the things I'd read about with my own two eyes.
Maybe you didn't want to study, Millie, but I'm glad you did.
Huh?
I mean, you're super smart.
Really?
Please, stop that offensive giggling. What was that?
It's a Dark Service patrol ship.
All the way out here?
No, miss. The propulsion system! We're going down!
Good to see everybody safe.
Where are we?
Hey, hold on. This is the Hollow Hollow Jungle. Oh no, this is bad. Really, really bad.
What's wrong, Milliard? Is it bad?
Shut up, Dingbat!
Seriously, what's wrong, Millie?
They say that even the most seasoned travelers get lost in this jungle. You need this rock called the Landmark Stone that's been bewitched by the headmaster of the School of Magic. Otherwise, you can never escape.
I get it. That is bad.
How can you be so calm? But I'm not ready to turn into hollow, hollow compost. You... Oh no.
I think it found us.
But look, it's carrying young. Doesn't that make it a friendly bird?
Why do I bother getting mad? The hollow hollow bird carries its young when it goes hunting for food.
Oh.
Which means it's hunting for food right now!
Stop arguing! This isn't...
More.
Whatever. Whatever!
Let's see you beat that, Dingbat.
I didn't really have time to notice before, but that is one big bird.
You certainly won't go hungry if we end up stranded here. It might even taste like clucker. Not that I'd know the difference.
Stop that. We can't just sit around, or Shanath and his goons will get a head start. Let's find some way out of this place.
I should stay here and try to repair the Svita. You continue the operation, Master Soggy. I'll have her up and running before you can say mission complete.
Thanks. I appreciate it. Look at the size of that elephant.
I think it's...
Stupid deep bat! Don't get so close! Elephants can turn really savage when they're upset. Especially right after they wake up.
Wow, Millie.
So it's...
Shut up! Now let's keep moving.
Hey, didn't we just pass through here?
I think we...
See?
Hey, Millie, do you know which way Komo Mai is?
The rainbow's over yonder, so I guess it would have to be... But what difference does it make?
Maybe we could get some help from the elephant. Didn't you say it charges when it gets mad?
I see. So we make our own trail.
Exactly. If we can just get it to wake up.
All right then. Let's get this pugnacious pachyderm out of bed.
That's the way to Komo Mai, right?
Uh-huh. And look, we've got a brand new road.
We certainly do, but
How far is that elephant going to run?
I hope we don't find Como Mayan ruins.
Hey! It wasn't my idea.
Smell all those flowers.
They call Como Mai the City of Flowers.
Weren't we supposed to meet with that Corellia person?
Queen Corellia should be at the palace. It's up in the center of town. This is so exciting!
Okay, center of town.
Oh, who might you be? This way leads to Queen Corellia's palace. If you...
Oh, I've come from Alfard on behalf of Quaestor Varys. My name is Sagi. I would be honored if I could have a moment of her grace, the fairy guide's time.
Ah, Master Sagi, we'd heard you were coming.
Forgive us for the misunderstanding. Let us escort you to the queen. Right this way. Queen Corellia, we've brought the emissaries from Alfard.
Thank you. Welcome to Anuenue. You've come quite a long way to see me.
Your Grace, I'd like to speak with you about the Empire's attempts to promachinate the world.
Machina. Yes, of course. I know of your plight.
Then, you'll help us, Your Grace.
Out of the question. The people of Anuenue are not fond of conflict. We have always stayed neutral and peaceful in matters.
And suppose the Machina Vanguard has already arrived on your soil. You think neutrality and that smug little grin will stop them?
I assure you, if promachination shows signs of spreading into Anuenue, I shall take the necessary action. However, as of yet, I've heard no such news. There's nothing more to discuss.
I understand, Your Grace. I'll explain your position to the Quaestor.
But... Sagi?
What else can we do? Yeah. It's not like she's siding with Promachination. Let's report to the Quaestor and see what he thinks.
Did you just... You wouldn't happen to be a spiriter?
Huh? Me?
Is that... If you've no further business with me, then kindly leave. Tell Quaestor Varys I cannot be of help to him.
Yes, Your Grace. Sir, we weren't able to secure Queen Corellia's help, but she doesn't seem to be in support of Promachination either.
Ever the pacifist, even now. All right, I suppose there's no point in pursuing the matter further. My guardian spirit has already cautioned me against pressuring the fairy guide. That concludes your mission. Good work. Return to Mintaka.
Yes, sir.
Orders to withdraw?
Yeah. Let's go back to the Hala Hala jungle. Repairs to the Sfida should be done by now.
Wait! As long as we're in Komomai, why don't we stop at the School of Magic?
You mean the school you went to?
That's the one. It's a repository for all the world's knowledge. Maybe we could learn something about that strange world we keep finding ourselves.
That's true. Want to go take a look? Yeah. Plus, I've always wanted to see what a school is like.
Master Soggy, am I glad to see you?
What's wrong? The Sphita still seems to be having some trouble.
Yes. You see, they hit a crucial part of the drive system. I don't see a way to fix her with the parts I've got handy. And even if I did have the parts I need, she's taken quite a beating. To be honest, I'm not sure I have the skills to put her back in the air.
I see. What a mess. Got any ideas? Yeah, we could ask the Quaestor to send us another ship. This time, a huge one that can pick up the Sphita and everything.
Hey, that's not bad.
Okay.
This is Geldeblame. What is it, Soggy?
Oh, Geldeblame. The Dark Service attacked, and the Sphita took a lot of damage.
What? That's terrible.
We're having trouble repairing it here. Is there any way you could send a large ship to Anuenue?
As much as I'd love to say I'll have it there in a flash, Quaestor Varus is away at the moment, and I don't have the authority. Can you make things work on that end?
Well, I'll certainly try.
I'm sorry. When the Quaestor returns, I'll pass him your message.
Please do. It's no good. The Quaestor's out, so we can't get a ship.
That's fine with me. I don't care one jot if we wait right here.
No stinking way! We don't know when another one of those birds will come swooping in again. Come on, let's go ask Queen Corellia.
All right, sure. Let's go.
Let's see you beat that, dingbat.
Queen Corellia is off meditating at the vein roots of the Celestial Tree. I'll be happy to assist you in her stead. What seems to be the matter?
We wanted to ask for help with ship repairs. The vessel we came in on?
I see. Well, that's a reasonable request, but I'm afraid we cannot help you.
You're not going to start preaching to us about neutrality again.
That is a concern, but it's not the only concern. As you can see, Anuenue is one with nature. We simply don't have the means to repair a ship made from machina.
That's true, now that you mention it.
Perhaps you should consider dropping by the School of Magic. It houses all sorts of knowledge, magical and otherwise. You might just...
Guys, check this out.
Liar?
Yeah, but I...
Really?
Okay.
Noisy little whelps.
This is... But look at the gadgetry inside that toy.
Hey, that's it.
What do you mean?
Well, whoever designed the gadgetry in that toy might know how to repair the Sphida.
Isn't that a stretch?
We've got nothing to lose. They said someone named Lolo made it, right?
Yeah. Let's see if we can track her down.